Okay, so our topic was that all 50 states should be recognized, or should not be recognized by the federal and state governments. The institution of marriage has traditionally been defined as between a man and a woman. On October 15, 1971, decision Baker versus Nelson, the Supreme Court of Minnesota found that the institution of marriage as a union of man and woman mutually involved in the procreation of marrying children within a family is as old as the Book of Genesis. Gay marriage is incompatible with the beliefs and sacred texts and traditions of many religious groups. The Catholic Church, Presbyterian Church, Islam, United Methodist Church, Southern Baptist Convention, Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, National Association of Evangelicals, and American Baptist Churches, USA, all oppose same-sex marriage. Expanding marriage to include same-sex couples may lead to churches being forced to many couples and children being taught in the same school. In the same school that same-sex marriage is the same as heterosexual marriage. This can be an issue for parents and also for the community. Approving same-sex marriage legally can start programs within the education. And when you start programs, it cuts other programs, and that's also a problem. And also for the parents and that have no say, maybe they want to teach their children differently. My opponent talked about the economy and how same-sex marriage can benefit. People should not have their tax dollars used to support something that they believe is wrong. Gay marriage would entitle gay couples to typical marriage benefits, including a tax exemption for a spouse, receiving Social Security payments from a deceased spouse, and coverage by a spouse's health insurance policy. On December 17, 2009, the Congressional Budget Office estimated that the cost to the federal government of extending employment benefits to same-sex domestic partners of certain federal employees would be $596 million in mandatory spending and $302 million in discretionary spending between 2010 and 2019. Same-sex marriage is not a civil rights issue, and conflating the issue with interracial marriage is misleading. Matthew D. Staver, the dean of Liberty University School of Law, explained the unifying characteristics of the protected classes within the Civil Rights Act of 1964. Include one, a history of longstanding widespread discrimination, two, economic disadvantage, and three, immutable characteristics. Sexual orientation does not meet any of these three objective criteria shared by the historically protected civil rights categories. Same-sex marriage turns the civil rights issue into a moral wrong. Homosexual activists argue that same-sex marriage is a civil rights issue similar to the struggle for racial equality in the 1960s. This is false. First of all, sexual behavior and race are essentially different realities. A man and a woman wanting to marry may be different in their characteristics. One may be black, the other white, one rich and the other poor, or one tall and the other short. None of these differences are insurmountable obstacles to marriage. The two individuals are still man and woman, and thus the requirements of nature are respected. This same-sex marriage opposes nature. Two individuals of the same sex, regardless of their race, wealth, stature, erudition, or fame, will never be able to marry because of an insurmountable biological possibility.